Hi, we will be taking a few questions and try to solve. Recommend that you try to solve on your own first before you look at the solutions. You can pause the video, try to solve on your own, and then check the solution for yourself. So we have kite PQRS, where PQ equal to PS. So we'll draw the kite. So PQ, R, and S. That's a kite. PQ equal to PS and RQ equal to RS. Angle QPR, this angle is equal to QSR. And X is angle QPR plus QRP. What is the value of X? Now you can, in a figure or in any sum, you can assume anything as long as it satisfies all constraint. So I can assume this to be a square. Okay, I can assume this to be a square because a square also is a type of kite. So in that case, each of this angle will become 45 and this angle also will become 45. It satisfies the constraint given to you. All the three constraints, PQ equal to PS, RQ equal to RS, and angle this equal to angle this. You can draw any diagram as long as it satisfies any constraint. Now we want angle QPR, which we know is 45, plus QRP, which will also be 45. Right? This angle also will be 45. So 45 plus 45 is 90. Now check out which option has 90. Look at B option. So that has to be the answer. So one of the easy way of solving, you know, what people do mistake is they try to put too much of mathematics, put formulas, put equations, and try to get the answer. The simple techniques, and if you get used to it, it becomes much easier to solve. So in this case, if you just assume the kite as a square and you get the answer immediately, and that is what these techniques is what you need to learn to crack the examination. It saves you a lot of time and you get your marks too. The average marks of a class of 60 students is 28, and average students who passed is 32, and average of those who failed, okay, is 12. So basically 28 is nothing but the average of 32 and 12. So here where you can use allegation. Allegation is a good method in average, which helps you to solve fast. And allegation normally used when the average is given to you. So 28 average is given to you. So you're mixing people who passed and failed to get 28. So allegation is where you subtract 32 minus 28, 4, 28 minus 12, 16. So the ratio of the students of pass and fail is 4 is to 1. Now 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 stands for 60. 5 stands for total students, which is 60. So number of students who passed will be 5 12s are 60. So 4 12s are 48. So you will get the answer as A option. As per new time, 1 hour is 20 minutes. A clock shows 36 hours on a dial and 120 minutes per hour. What's the angle of degree between the hour and the minute hand at 1860? First, let's look at. Now, 36 hours is one circle. On the dial means it shows total 36 hours on one dial. And 36 hours is nothing but 360 degrees. So, which means 1 hour will be 10 degrees. So, we understand 1 hour is 10 degrees. So distance between 1 hour is 10 degree. Now when you say 1860, 18 means it's exactly half. That means the hour hand will be at the bottom, 18. Sorry, hour hand will be down, minute hand will be 60. 60 is down because total is 120 minutes. So 60 will be exactly down. Total is 36 hours. So the hour hand will be exactly between 18 hour and 19 hours. 18 hours will be at the bottom and 19 hours will be next. So hour and will be exactly between 18 and 19. That means the angle between these two is half the hour. Now we know 1 hour is 10 degree. So half the hour will be 5 degree. I repeat, first step is 36 hours is 360 degree. So 1 hour is 10 degree. Second, now try to place the hands in the clock. Since there are total 120 minutes, so at 60 minutes, at 60 minutes, the minute hand will be exactly at the bottom. And the hour hand will be between the 18th hour and the 19th hour, exactly in between. So you can make out the angle between them will be half the hour. If 1 hour is 60 degree, half the hour will be 5 degree. That will be the answer. How many triangles are there in a given figure? You need to be systematic. Now look at how the triangles are. There are only two ways of triangle. One is such a triangle and one is like this triangle. There are only two ways of having a triangle in this case, where the base is at the bottom, base at the top. Any way else you pick up a triangle, it will be one of these two types. So let's start with these type of triangles first. So I'm looking at it. So first triangle can be here, okay, with this. Second, third, I'm talking about looking at the tips. How many tips are possible? So one here, two here, three here, four here. So total 10 triangles, smaller triangles of side one. Now let me take side two, a bigger triangle like this. How many are possible? Okay, one here, again two here, bigger triangles, and three here. Okay, three big triangles. One, two, and three. So we have six more. Now we take side of three. If I take side of three, bigger, how many such triangles are formed? One using this tip, two using these tips. So this and this, which becomes three. This is side one. This is side two. This is side three. Side three means one length as a side, two lengths as a side, and three lengths as a side. And if I take fourth length as a side, it's the bigger triangle, the biggest triangle which is there. That will be one. So you can form 20 such triangles with this. Now let's look at reverse this way triangles with side one. So my tip has to be at the bottom, or my base has to be here. So I will have base one out here, two out here, and three out here. So one base, two base, three base. For triangles, one base, second, two, and third, three base. So it becomes six triangles with one side. If I take two sides, two in a sense, the length is two, the bigger one, like this, which has this. So if you look at, I can form one triangle out here, big triangle. So total seven triangles can be formed out here. Okay, so total 20 plus 7, 27 is the answer. There's no option anywhere more than 27. You need not check more than that. What is important out here is to be systematic. I first try to find out how the triangles are placed, straight and reversed. I counted all the straight triangles with sides 1, side 2, side 3, side 4. Then reverse triangle with side 1 and side 2. Side 3 is not possible. You don't get a triangle with side 3. So automatically 27. So automatically the answer is 27 in this case. P starts a business with capital of 15,000. So P starts capital of 15,000 in 12 months. Q starts a business. We don't know the capital. Let's say Q for 8 months. And R starts a business. We don't know capital. Let's say R for 6 months. After 6 months, nothing. Let's take P and Q first. We know the ratio of P and Q is 18:16. So equate it. 15,000 into 12 upon Q into 8 should be equal to 18 upon 16. If you solve it, you will get Q equal to 15,000 into 12 upon 8 into 18 into 16. If you solve this, 9 will get cancelled out here with 4 and here with 5,000. We will get the answer as 20,000 here in the first case. Just the equation of ratios. Now we look at P and R. P is 15,000 into 12 upon, it is R into 6 is equal to ratio is 18 upon 15. So 6 gets cancelled, 2 gets cancelled, 9. You can do R is equal to 15,000 into 15 upon 9. 9 will get cancelled with here 5 and here 5,000. You'll get R as 25,000. The total value of 20,000 plus 25,000 is 45,000. Right? So you can solve this and try to get the answer accordingly. So it is a little bit of calculation, but if you're good at calculation, you can do this fast. Okay. So that should help. I hope this is clear with regards to sum. Thank you.